Okay, welcome back. Last time we challenged, well, we did everything we needed to do around Violet City and then challenged Violet City Gym. And then ended the episode having made our way all the way down to Union Cave on the way to Azalea Town. In between episodes, I didn't really do anything of note. Pretty much all I did was I went and hatched those three eggs. And pretty much this is what we ended up with. We had Cacturn, which I can't use. Victory Bell, which I can't use, even though it has Razor Leaf, which would be very nice. And we also got Seal, which just had Headbutt, and only Headbutt. But yeah, we can't use any of these, so I'm just gonna put them into this box. So yeah, we'll never be using. Nope, I don't want to get rid of my Magnemite. And the other egg is the one that we actually can use. And we can now also pick up Wooper, who I'm going to quickly transition the lucky egg onto. Because we're going to be going through a cave, which means there's going to be plenty of rock types for it to get experience from. Now, how do I... Oh, right, switch. There we go. Pretty much, since we're going into a cave, there's going to be a whole bunch of Geodudes and Onyxes and stuff, and that means Wooper is pretty much free to get experience. And I say that, however, I know that this guy here is a bird keeper, so I'm actually going to quickly give Magnemite the lucky egg back when I fight this guy. And then when we actually go into the cave, that's when I'll give Wooper the whatchamacallit, lucky egg. And also, because we're playing Soulsilver, we won't have a potential Sandshrew encounter in here, because spoilers, Sandshrew can appear in Union Cave and Heart Gold, but since we're playing Soulsilver, Ekans appeared on the route that we were just on, but Sandshrew does not appear. And Valkyrian is learning Sonic Boom, and that is absolutely fantastic. Mostly just because having Sonic Boom and also Dragon Rage, because Dragon Rage is just double Sonic Boom, basically. It's just Sonic Boom with double damage. Which, like, as many people that have had Nuzlocke's ruined by it will tell you, very helpful to have, especially early game. Because just a set amount of damage that, where you don't need to worry about resistances or anything, super helpful. However, I do now need to be a bit wary because Magnemite is level 14 and my cap is pretty close to that. Pretty much now all I need to worry about is, pretty much as long as Wooper doesn't die, I'm going to be pretty okay and happy with this episode. Okay, into Union Cave, where we are effectively guaranteed Onyx as an encounter, because we already have Zubat, and we already had Geodude. So pretty much all I need to do now is run away from every Zubat I see. Because Zubat could be a potential threat to little Wooper there. And what do we have here? Another Zubat, because of course we do. Why would we ever find the rock types in the cave? Oh no. Actually, since we're playing with the boosted moves, Leech Life could do a ton of damage if it hurts. And also, since there's a 10% level boost, you know, things will be hitting a bit harder, and I forgot that there were rat in this cave as well. And Wooper is unfortunately also not the fastest Pokemon in the world. Okay, how much will this hit for? Too much is the answer. The answer is it will hit for too much. Okay, I'm gonna swap out, I'm gonna heal. Let me go swap out, I'm gonna knock out Miss Rata, then I'm gonna go back to the Pokemon Center, heal, and then hopefully we'll actually find rock types and things that Wooper can fight. Because as much as I love Wooper, I don't want it dying this quickly. You know, because losses are never fun, and I already had one, like, given how I lost the Geodude in the previous episode, I don't want a repeat of that at any level ever, really. And it also just hit me that I have the old rod. I could theoretically fish in the cave. But at the same time, I think my encounters there would only be Magikarp and Tentacool. And I can get those basically anywhere. I mean, I say that... Like, I say that, but at the same time, I'm probably more likely to use a Magikarp or a Tentacool than I am an Oryx. But we finally found a rock type, so hopefully... we can just one-shot... Like, it's quite effective at stab. I assume we'll one-shot with Water Gun. You know, now that with the additional context that our Geodude was level 9 and got critted by a quad effect of Divine Whip and died, like, I can definitely say that the crit mattered. Okay, so we'll fight this guy, because obviously he's a hiker and hikers tend to have rock types. Well, they have rock and ground types. Late end game, they often adopt having, like, Machop and things as well. Oh, but they usually tend to stick with, like, the Geodude line, the Onix line, and the Machop line. At least in Gen 1 and 2, anyway. And, okay, we got a crit, and also... Okay, we won't die from one hit of Bind. And with the Lucky Egg, that 5-level gap will probably turn into a massive chunk of experience. Which means... Okay, 415 is a very healthy amount to get. Damn, that's just 2 levels in one... That's 2 levels straight away and Mudshot. That is fantastic. 10 out of 10, Wooper immediately becoming very worthwhile. Actually, hang on, wait, if I go up, Yeah, I'm gonna have to double back, because I think if you go up, there's actually a couple of items that I missed. There's also a Fire Breather trainer there, I think. And obviously, since we have Wooper now, we should be able to deal with him pretty handily. And by that, I mean, I didn't want to have to fight him when my only real Pokemon that could handle it was Hoothoot, because Magnemite... I don't really want to put Magnemite near Fire types if I can avoid it. Like, if I find a TM for, like, Thunderbolt or something and a Tidro Pump, then I'll consider it. Or if I find a way to somehow get Surf onto it, then definitely. But otherwise, I would like to keep it as far away from Fire types as possible. Also, 10 out of 10. The Lucky Egg, absolutely broken. I'm so happy I found one early in the game. Because, honestly, grinding in Gen 2 is miserable a lot of the time. I think grinding in Gen 2 is maybe the worst in the entire series. Like, if you just had the versus Seeker, it would be fine. Oh, and we got a Magnet. So, technically, I'm now giving a Magnet to our Magnet to make its electricity stronger. Maybe that's the second Magnet that makes it Magneton. I think I actually mentioned it in... I think I mentioned it in Emerald. But when I was a kid, it always kind of weirded me out that Magneton was basically... Like, when I was a kid, it always kind of weirded me out that Magneton was 3 Magnemites pretty much put together. But it didn't have triple the stats. That's of a Magnemite. Because, logically... Like, I thought that made perfect sense. It's 3 of them together, so they would be 3 times as strong. Like, am I wrong? Like, was child me wrong? Like, I think that makes perfect sense. Or at least I thought that made perfect sense. Then I actually learned what base stats and everything were and realized if you actually just tripled Magnemite's base stats, that's for its evolved form, it would probably be better. It would probably be the best Pokemon in the game. Because it would be like... Okay, TM90 for Faint Attack? What is TM90 normally? Is the big question here. TM90? Can I teach it anything? I can teach it to everything. Wait, is TM 90 substitute? I think it might be substitute. Because if I can just teach faint attacks to any Pokemon I get, that is fantastic. Also, apparently even with the level gap, we can't quite just run away from a Rattata. Okay, that hit for 9, so we should be safe, and my control has gone off for some reason. Okay, there we go. Okay, it uses focus energy. Alright. And we miss Mudshot, a great start for that move. Okay, that does 9. At minus one, do we outspeed? I think the answer is probably yes, but honestly, I'm not gonna take that chance. Okay, so we get hit with Tail Whip and we lose one defense, but that's fine. We just peck and finish it off the Rattata. And now I'm gonna double back to the Pokemon Center again. Actually, do I want a double back to the Pokemon Center? Do I have healing items? I have 5 potions, that's fine. Like, I'm allowed to use healing items outside of battle, it's just not in battle. Okay, yeah, I have some pretty decent TMs. And so far, I'm very happy with what I have access to. Okay, a Reaper Cloth, if we somehow end up with a Dusclops, we can get Dusk Noir. And Dusk Noir is really cool. I actually recently got a shiny Duskull in Sword and Shield. I say recently, I think I caught it in, September. And that is kind of recent, I guess. I think, to be totally honest, I don't understand how shiny hunting works in some games. I also have recently increasingly realized I absolutely do not have the patience for it. I have a few shinies in my games, but, I do not have the patience. Credit to the people who can, because I absolutely do not have the patience to sit and just grind that out. Yes, it isn't exactly difficult, but at the same time, it's just so much stuff. But I was very glad when I managed to have shiny Charmander in Sword and Shield. Yield in, I think that was 48 eggs. But the previous one for that was at 1023 or something. Oh, that's an Onix. That's our actual encounter in here. That is kind of cool, because since I bought a metal coat, I can also turn that into Steelix if I so choose. And having Steelix this early might actually be really good. But at the same time, it is still just an Onix. Okay, so what do I want to name Onix? Let's see here. Okay. So, in the Pokemon anime, when Ash first reaches Pewter City, he meets a guy called Flint, who actually turns out to be Brock's dad. So I named the Onix Flint. And I'm sure you may be wondering, why didn't you just name it Brock if you're gonna do that? To which I have a very simple answer. I don't know. Okay, so now we just heal up and then head straight on back into the cave. I'm not adding Onix to the layout because, as honestly, it's just an Onix I'm probably not using on my team. But just for convenience sake, let's have a quick look at it. Another lonely natured Pokemon. I'm just finding all the lonely Pokemon in this playthrough, huh? Okay, so, it has Screech, which is actually pretty helpful. Oh, and how close is this to hatching? Doesn't seem like it will hatch anytime soon. I mean, hopefully it'll take ages. Hopefully if it takes ages, it'll actually be something good. However, I know my luck, it will probably be something middling to mediocre. Because, I know what. Okay, what'll it be? I'll take a guess and say it'll be a Ninjask or something. One of those kind of middle of the road Pokemon that it's not absolute roadkill, but it's not... It's not absolute garbage, but it's not something that you see and you're just excited about. I'm not expecting to just, like, hatch this egg and see an Infernape pop out. Don't get me wrong, if an Infernape pops out of that egg, I will be overjoyed, because I absolutely love Infernape. And by that, I mean, Chimchar Gang? It's my favorite. I'll be real, Chimchar's my favorite starter. 100%, out of all of the starters in mainline Pokemon, absolutely my favorite. I think my favorite starter overall ever in Pokemon, it kind of has to go to Colosseum, but that's because Colosseum is cheating in that regard, because it gives you an Umbreon and an Espeon as your starter Pokemon. And you don't have a choice, you just have Umbreon and Espeon. And, you know, it's kind of hard to argue against, two super good Pokemon. Even though admittedly, I'm not a massive fan of Umbreon. I definitely like Espeon a lot more than Umbreon. And, that's not really, a bias thing, it's not really a spoiler, because Dark type is my favorite type. I bet there's a, Psychic is probably, middle of the road typing for me. I don't dislike it, but there's not many Psychic types that I'm excited to see pop up in my game. However, one of them is actually, how many of them can I get in this game? There's two or three that I could get in this game, aside from, potential stacks. Aside from potential stacks, because who knows, I might go up to that Sudowoodo and it could be an Alakazam for all I know. If it's an Alakazam, I don't know if I'm catching or running. Because, at that level, an Alakazam might... It would definitely know confusion. So it might be able to just, wipe my team off the face of the earth in, two hits. Also, I don't remember what this guy has. I feel like he probably has a Zubat. But, I don't know. I don't know. What does he have? Oh, no, it's a Slowpoke. Okay. And that means... I'm just gonna go to a Valkyrian for this, because it would take forever otherwise. Okay, so he just uses Growl, which really won't do anything. And pretty much just a... No. Okay, I guess this is how he's playing. I was gonna say I was gonna use Metal Sound just to, lock in the guaranteed Oko. But apparently we don't even need it with the level gap, the super effective stab, and the magnet. And also, the Lucky Egg has really just brought Wooper up to, Wooper is now on level with the rest of the team already. And, my mind has just gone today. We got seven... Wooper got seven levels in this cave. And the reason I'm kind of holding back on using Hoothoot is because I'm going to let Hoothoot handle pretty much the entire gym. And hopefully, the key term is hopefully, if Hoothoot can handle the gym and go into the actual gym battle at level 17, if it goes over, if we surpass the cap in the gym battle itself, that's fine. But if it goes up to level 18 before I fight Bugsy, I'm not allowed to use it until I beat him. Also, I don't remember if it's always raining on this route, but I feel as if it is. I don't think it is, but I'm... let me try to rephrase this. I don't think it's always raining on this route, but it seems like it is whenever I'm playing. Maybe it's because I always tend to come through this area at night. And also, there is another encounter out here, I think. Because I think this is Route 33. Even though this is an absolutely tiny route with barely anything on it. And it's literally just a transitional, tiny... it's just a transitional tiny little area on the way between the exit of Union Cave and Azalea Town. Also, we have a 6-level gap. I should just be able to auto-run, but you know what? Okay, there we go. I was going to say, I'll just water-gun it, because I'll one-shot, especially since we're in the rain. Especially since we are in the rain. And that is an Ekans as an encounter. Okay. Ekans is not bad. I would kind of welcome an Ekans. I mean, I say that, it probably wouldn't be going on the team, especially not straight away. But an Ekans could be worse. And by that, I mean I will take Ekans over having a Hopper. And I'm sure that, yes, Jumpluff, Skiploom, Jumpluff, they actually, do have... they have stuff that could make them useful, but, it's just a hassle keeping a Hopper alive for that long. Okay, that drops the Ekans low. Also, a very helpful thing about Gen 4, your Pokemon no longer die to poison outside of battle. So I can now swap out. So I just swap out to Magnemite, and now we can start throwing Pokeballs at the Ekans. And then when I actually get to the PC, I will double check just to make sure that this Ekans is legal to potentially be used on the team at a later time. Okay, so in the ball it goes. 1, 2, 3, and it stayed in the ball. 10 out of 10, love it when that happens. Always hides in the grass when first born, it has no poison, so its bite is painful but harmless. Interesting. I'm not a massive fan of snakes, to be totally honest. I'm just going to call it Orochi. There we go. I think my one in Fire Red I named Orochimaru, but whatever. Orochi works. Okay, Rash Nature. It does have Intimidate. Honestly, even if I just kept this as a Sackmon, that would be very helpful, because Intimidate is an amazing ability, especially in Nuzlocke. Mostly because... also, instead of the just, complete screen thing going, and they did change it in Gen 4, so it's just kind of, the sides of the screen sort of shake. Also, yeah, this is what... yeah, basically, there's Team Rocket, just, hassling a guy in town. And because, Team Rocket love hassling people in town. Okay, Azalea Town, living happily with Pokemon. Slowpoke have disappeared, and Team Rocket are selling their tails somewhere. Okay, what is in here? Rock incense? Or the Razor Fang? Oh, that could be super helpful. And lemonade. Okay, that's very helpful as well. The Razor Fang, though? The Razor Fang, if... wait. The Razor Fang might come in handy. Or it might be completely useless. I know that it's used to evolve Gligar in a Gliscor. However, I don't remember if Gligar is a region exclusive. I don't remember if it's only in Heart Gold or if it's also in Soulsilver. I mean, look, if I get access to a Gliscor, I'm absolutely probably going to use it because I really like Gliscor. And I've never actually used one in Gen 4. I've used one in Gen 5. I think I've used one in Gen 6. And honestly, it became one of my favorite Pokemon in Gen 5. And, what do I want to do now? I guess I'll put that Valkyrian back to the front of the party and also give it the lucky egg. I accidentally turned on speed up for a second. And I want to give the lucky egg back. And now Magnemite, won't be Magneton for a little while. It should be able to handle all of the Team Rocket stuff just by itself. And also, the white apricorn. I mean, it's rather fitting that one of, if not the best apricorns, is just right next to the apricorn ball creator's house. Like, I think the red and the white apricorns are definitely the best ones. They make the level ball and the fast ball. And honestly, they're just so practical and helpful a lot of the time. And while I'm here, I should also go and get my... Actually, should I have an Elex Forest encounter now or later? I'll do the Elex Forest encounter later. Because one thing that is also kind of important to know is once you beat Team Rocket, once you get them out of... Once you force Team Rocket to leave Azalea Town and clear them out of the Slowpoke Well... Well, because like, as of right now, I can walk into the Elex Forest. Once I beat Team Rocket, and they leave, trying to leave town will cause a rival battle to happen. Where, actually, he had Badoo the last time we fought him. So maybe he'll have Roselia this time. Okay, so pretty much that's just going, yeah, Team Rocket are stealing, Slowpoke tails, and I'm gonna go stop them. And, well, he made it to the well, at least. He made it to the well, then he fell down the well. Fortunately, this is a rather well-built well that, you know, has a cave and everything next to it. Also, Tatan, I like how he's just like, oh, my Pokemon could have handled it. It's just like, which Pokemon do you have? Can I battle you at some point? And the answer is no, you can't fight him. I'm sure there's probably a ROM hack where you can. And, like, I'm sure someone's probably, like, made up a team for him and everything. But, like, as far as I'm aware, I've never seen a battle with Kurt. And also... Okay, yeah. We're only level 10. This'll be easy. We'll just find a shark. And also, I know that the boss here, Groton, I know that he does have a coffin. However, I don't think it should be at a level where it would have access to self-destruct yet. Which is very good, because I don't want to have to deal with self-destructs in the early game. In an ideal world, I wouldn't have to deal with self-destruct at any point in the Pokemon game. But, using self-destruct and explosion is definitely more Petrel's style. And we'll be encountering him in... a while. Like, he doesn't turn... Like, he is a good few episodes away from here. Like, we'll have... We will have more badges by the time we fight him. Oh, hang on, wait, what's this? Oh, okay, just a normal rappel. Okay, so there's three trainers in here and then Proton, who's the boss. So that shouldn't take too long. Okay, so this Rocket Grunt has a Zubat, which obviously is just gonna get hit with Thundershock and get one-shotted. Because of course, super effective, stab, 5-level gap. Up and with that. Okay, I'm gonna bring in Ekans, so I'm gonna swap out and go to Hiruzen for this. It's because I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna be using him for the next episode or two. Well, at least not much in the next episode or two. Okay, Ekans uses a poison sting, I'll do like 3 damage. Okay, apparently I vastly overestimated Ekans. And Mudshot does, like, what, 75%? 75? Yeah, like, somewhere between 66 and 75%. I'm bad at, just sight-reading stuff sometimes. Either way, 2 Mudshots brings down the Ekans, and we defeat this grunt without any real issues. Also, that's kind of messed up. It's just like, yeah, we still have Slowpoke tails, but if they grow back quick, that doesn't justify it. Okay, we found a Lucky Punch on this rock, but I'll be real, we will never find a use for the Lucky Punch because we more than likely aren't going to get a Chansey. Oh, a Slowpoke. That is fantastic as an encounter. I mean, as far as I'm aware, without fishing or surfing, it is quite literally the only encounter that we could have gotten. But you know what? In the event that we lose Wooper, having a water psychic type that's... Having a bulky water psychic type like Slowpoke is very nice to have. And... I don't have a name plan for this. You know what? I'm gonna name it Nougat. We're gonna name it Nougat because it is pink and its tail is white. It's primarily pink and white, and I never as well always written colors I associated with Nougat, so yeah, we now have Nougat the Slowpoke, and it doesn't have Confusion or Water Gun yet. Hang on, wait. What nature was it? Docile. And it has highest physical attack than special. Love to see it. And by that I mean, you really don't love to see it, but whatever, it'll be fine. And I like how their logic is just like, well, if we... I do love how this guy's entire argument is just like, well, if we listened to the people that told us to not do crime, we wouldn't be criminals. Like, that's some very straightforward, understandable logic there from that guy. It's just like, well, if criminals didn't do crime, they wouldn't be criminals. It's just like, yeah, don't do crime. As a general rule, crime is bad. However, I'm recording this like a week or two after the new Spider-Man movie came out, and all the conversation around that reminded me I want to say it's at the end or maybe a post-credit scene in the Amazing Spider-Man 2, where the Rhino turns up, and I don't think I have ever seen a man enjoying what he does more than the Rhino in that movie. That man just loves doing crime. So much. Man really has a passion for it. Oh, also, this is Executive Photon. He's the first, Team Rocket admin that you encounter. And, well, he has level 9 Zubat, which obviously gets one shot. And he also has a Coughing, which will be, level 13 or 14. And, it's level 13. And also, it's probably gonna get knocked out in 2 hits. Yeah, that's a 2-hit hit deal. And also, yes, as a general rule, yeah, people do tend to disagree with Team Rocket's ideals and plans, because their plans usually involve crime and stealing people's Pokemon. And, you know, people kinda like being around Pokemon. Okay, that guy, never saw it coming. Okay, Team Rocket broke up 3 years ago, continued its activities underground. And, yeah, just like, oh, they're hinting that they're gonna be important in this game as well. But yeah, we've now saved the Slowpoke, and Team Rocket's... Also, Kurt really recovered from a injured back very quickly. Okay, and also, that's the first reference to Red, who obviously is the super boss at the end of this game. Also, another explanation for Fastball being the best of the Apricorn balls. It's the one they give you as the example. However, I won't actually be trading in the Apricorns just yet. I'm just gonna collect it. I'm gonna collect more, and then I'll just make a ton of them later. Okay, now that we've dealt with Team Rocket in Azalea Town, and I'm going to save and end off the episode, and in the next one, we are going to finish off everything we have left to do in Azalea Town, which is the gym, and then our second encounter with the rival, and then make our way through the Elex Forest and up to Goldenrod City. And from there, we can actually do a fair bit in Goldenrod. But that'll probably be the episode after that. But anyway, in between episodes, I might hatch this egg as well. That is all stuff for the next episode. So I will hopefully see you all for that next time. Okay, later!